Hi guys, this is Matai the Dead doing a review in a different surrounding for now of this video. I'm not going to go into details. I'm just essentially house sitting for someone. So they don't have internet, so I thought, what can I do? So I thought I'd bring the MacBook and shoot a video, do a review of a film that it's took me a few nights to watch, mainly because of stuff happening like The Walking Dead. And the fact that I just kept getting interrupted. And it took me a few nights to watch this film. Not because it dragged or anything like that, but purely because of those reasons. Trust me, this is not a bad film at all, and I'll get into that in a minute. But first, I'd like to thank Ian, aka Already Obsolete, for sending me this film. It's not the film he wants me to review for the reason why he sent me the films, if you get me. But it's one of the films that he sent, very, very, awesome of him to do so. Just so many great titles. I watched a couple of them, and this one that I watched, I enjoyed it so much that I had to do a review of it. And so yeah, his link will be down below, guys. And he doesn't make videos, but he's very, active. In fact, for the reasons why this package happened in the first place. We got talking about Polish cinema, and he was telling me some films that I should check out, and he said, if you review this film, I'll send you it. So, I thought, awesome. And I still am trying to find films to send you, mate, even though you didn't want to do a trade or anything like that. But I want to, repay you for this, because this is just awesome. So yeah, the film that I'm reviewing is one that was included in the package, and it's one that seemed to get the most reaction in the comments of the unboxing video, which I'll put the link down to that as well if you want to check that out. And that film is a French film. It's not a French horror. That's one little side note, not bashing anyone or anything like that, but a lot of people always seem to go on about French horror, saying, oh, the French are fantastic at making art. That's true, but films like this that I'm going to talk about are the reason why I love French cinema. And I apologize for my hair, it looks like a wig right now. Tangent. But yeah, this film really cements it down why I love not just French cinema, but European cinema in general, especially modern contemporary European cinema. This film was from 1995, and that is a film called La Haine, which is the French translation of the word hate, which is a very, very suitable title for this film. And it's directed by Matthew Kasowitz, who I'm not too familiar with his work. It's one of those cases where I've probably watched films in the past by him, but I've not done any research on this. I'm just giving an off-the-cuff review of this one, because I don't want to get too much about what the film's, the ins and outs of the film. I just want to really tell you why I love this film. And it's directed by Matthew Kasowitz, starring the phenomenal Vincent Cassel, who I just love him. He's just so just watchable. Even when he's just stood there, there's just something about his face, his complexion, that is just, you want to see more. And this goes for this film as well. It also stars Hubert Colunde and also Saeed Taghi Mawi. I think that's how you pronounce it. Of course, most of you guys will probably know a lot more than me about these actors. But yeah, as I'm maturing and as I'm becoming more aware, it's films like this that just make me want to go back and think, oh, I remember a film with him in it and he did such and such. I want to look, do you know what I mean? It's enticing me to look up more films. And yeah, La Haine, which is basically a story about three guys, like three disenfranchised and socially neglected, I don't want to say youths, because I think they're like in the low 20s to mid 20s. And they live in a part of Paris that you don't see on any tourist map. It's the dark side of France. The France that, you know, you don't really see that much in mainstream media. You know, it's all about, oh, Eiffel Tower, baguettes and romance. Well, this is completely putting all those ideas out of the window. In fact, it was shot in black and white to hammer that message down, which I think works really, really well, because it's just a gloomy looking place. A lot of people don't like black and white. People say, oh, they only did black and white to make it, you know, have artistic value. This is not the case. If this was done in colour, I don't think it would have had the same impact on me. Not saying it would have been a terrible film. One second, though. So, yeah, essentially there's a reason for the black and white. So, yeah, stylistically, it looks gorgeous. Even though, you know, what you're seeing is bleak, it's shot brilliantly. Some of the architecture, even though, you know, it's in a downbeat area, it's just, it just fascinates me. I like seeing stuff like this. You could have a city in, you know, a few miles away that I'd never been to before, and I'd fall in love with it. And you could have, like, you know, to me, no cities look the same. You know, you could have the same building in two different countries, and I'd still be fascinated by that building in, you know, France or whatever. So it's really nice to see some brilliantly set up shots. It's just an absolutely gorgeous, you know, gorgeously put together film. But yeah, it's set in, you know, the dark side of Paris, where, you know, you've got lots of ethnic minorities, you've got poverty, you've got people who, you know, the rest of society just look down upon. So it's following these three guys around, and they're getting into all sorts of, you know, trouble, especially with the police. The police in this are complete shits. And again, just a real eye-opener, especially for the times. It was revealing what was going on in France. Of course, I'm not too, you know, I haven't researched that much into it, but I'm aware of what's going on at the time. Of course, in 1995, I was, you know, too young to be, you know, taking notice of stuff like that. But yeah, there was lots of real, you know, tension, real violence on the streets, mass protests, just police as well, and police rarely, you know, being complete and utter arseholes. I'm not a fan of the police, by the way. So yeah, it's just following these guys around. One of their friends was injured during the riots, and you know, Vincent Cassel absolutely hates the pigs. He's always going on about them to his friends and stuff like that. And during one of the riots, he finds, yeah, a gun, and yeah, he's promising to take revenge for their friend that's in hospital. So they're going around. There's lots of like philosophical discussions. Some really funny dialogue between them. When there's jokes in this film, they're not lost in translation, which I really like. You don't laugh because of, what the hell did you just say? You laugh because it was funny. Lots of banter going on between the three friends, and there's, you know, lots of, you know, really funny dialogue aimed at the police in the situations. So, yeah, essentially, it's just following them around, getting into different situations, meeting other people who, you know, some come from similar backgrounds and some, you know, live in the high life. You know, there's drugs in this. There's, of course, violence. What I liked about this was they didn't, you know, focus too much on sex. There was no, you know, gratuitous, you know, sexual content, which is good. They focused more on, you know, the harsh realities of the time. Nothing is outlandish in this film. It's all believable. It's all realistic. In fact, it's inspired, you know, by stories of the time and stuff like that as well. And like it says on the back, it was a real eye-opener to the rest of Europe, saying, look what's going on. You know, you don't get to see this in the promotional videos and stuff like that. And I really like that aspect as well. So it's got a great story. There's twists and turns along the way, which I'm not going to ruin for you guys. Stuff that I didn't really see coming at times, but stuff that I did see coming, but they approached it in a way that I was not expecting. So it's just a really well-made film. Everyone who, you know, mentioned this film in the comments, you guys are was so right about this film. Not saying that I don't agree with anyone's opinions, but I take my opinions of my subscribers, you know, very high regard, especially if I get to know them and stuff. So yeah, real, real essential watching if you like, you know, cinema, basically. You don't necessarily have to be into this sort of genre, or you don't necessarily have to be, you know, one of the people like myself who is involved in filmmaking as well. This is a real, you know, filmmaker's film, I felt. Everything involved with it was awesome. The soundtrack was brilliant. I really enjoyed the soundtrack. Of course, being that it's got a very urban vibe to it, there was lots of, you know, French hip-hop going on in there. Which, again, I want to get hold of soundtrack and get to know more of the artists. Speaking of which, if anyone's familiar with the works of the late, great DJ Mehdi, then you're probably interested in some of the French hip-hop. In fact, one of his sets from 2009 has been released, which I'll put the link down below if you want to hear music that you could possibly hear in this film. So yeah, it's just all around a great film. Got some great moments in there, some iconic moments, especially with Vincent Cassel. There's a really great scene where there's a close-up of his eyes, like close-up of his face, and in the background, people that he's with are shooting. And, you know, he's terrified, and he's pumped up, and, you know, angry at the same time, and it's just so captivating. Even when they Vincent Cassel does the, you know, whole taxi driver in the mirror reference, it's just as iconic as the original, you know, Robert De Niro thing, in my opinion. So yeah, this is just a fantastic film. I cannot think of any bad points to this film at all. Of course, repeat viewings will be viewed in the future. Just because, not only because it was just an entertaining film that I could watch over and over again, but because of the undertones and the messages that it's trying to send. If you get familiar with the subject, then I could see this film being a real great, you know, not only a great film, but also a great historical document and a sign of the times. This is a really nice edition put out by Optimum on the Optimum World label. It's a Studio Canal film. You know, that's just a quality, Studio Canal is just a quality name there anyway. Packed full of features, which I haven't gone into. You get, there's, you know, it's remastered with a new subtitle track. You get commentary with Matthew Kasowitz, which I'm really looking forward to getting into. You've got scenes in colour, which I want to watch as well. You've got behind the scenes footage, After the Riot, an essay on Lehane by Keith Reeder, which is in the form of a fairly sizable booklet, and that's, when you see that, that's an iconic moment of the film as well. And yeah, it's just, I just absolutely adored this film. Ian, thank you so much for sending me this as well. This was just phenomenal. A real 10 out of 10. I have to say, I was just dumbstruck by it. I just enjoyed it so immensely, not only on, you know, on the level of a viewer, but also on the practical and technical side of it as well. It's a real filmmaker's film, and a real, you know, just a testament to French filmmaking. So guys, if you want to know more information about the film, like synopsis and stuff like that, I'll put the IMDb and also like Wikipedia page as well. I'll put trailers in the description as well for you guys to check out. Also, please check out Audio Obsolete. He's a fucking awesome guy. He didn't have to do this, but you know, he's just shown his passion for film, and that's why I love being here. And also check out those other links as well if you're interested in that music as well. I just thought it'd be a nice companion piece to the review. So yeah, apologies for waffling on, guys. I've talked way too long about this film now. And I just hope that you guys enjoyed the review. If you've seen the film, let me know what you guys think. Email. I'm pretty sure I know what the answer is going to be. But tell me your favourite parts. Tell me films like this that I should check out. And yeah, most of all, get some discussion going on between yourselves, guys, because I really love seeing when my videos do that. So yeah, that's been my review of Lehane. Awesome film, 10 out of 10, phenomenal. I loved every second of it. And until next time, guys, you're all awesome.